गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर केमिस्ट्री इन सर्विस टू मैनकाइंड। वी नो द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ केमिकल्स, द केमिकल सब्सटेंसेस डिस्कवर्ड बाय द केमिस्ट इज फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द मैनकाइंड टू मीट द नीड ऑफ द ह्यूमन बींग्स। वॉट एवर डिस्कवरीज being made by the chemistry, that is for the service to the mankind. And nowadays, in our day-to-day life, in almost every field, every activity of life, we are using the chemicals, the chemical substances. It may be our food, it may be clothing, shelter, health, education, entertainment, luxuries of life, household furniture, medicines, warfare, agricultural field. So in each and every field of life, we are using the chemical substances for the development, growth and development, to prosper our life. So the application of chemistry in your day-to-day life is vital. It is not limited to discuss. It is unlimited. So we have the separate branches that are called applied chemistry. There is a polymer chemistry, there is a industrial chemistry, okay? There is a medicinal chemistry, there is a pharmaceutical chemistry. So many branches are there to discuss about the application of chemistry and how to utilize the knowledge of chemistry for the development of the mankind. So separate branches are there, studies are there. However, we will discuss in today's class only in a nutshell. First of all, for the survival of the mankind, so the prime things are the food, clothing, shelter, health, education. Five things. Okay, so primarily health, food, clothing, shelter and health. So these things are essentially made by the chemist. For example, food. Let's see, food. Number one, food. So food is essential for the survival and growth of the animals. So we need food in the form of carbohydrates, proteins, amino acids, fats, oils. These things we need for survival and growth. But these carbohydrates, proteins, amino acids, fats, oils, we are getting from the grains, fruits and vegetables. So number one, for the production of these grains, fruits and vegetables, we are requiring different kind of chemicals. We are using different kind of fertilizers. By using the chemicals, pesticides, insecticides and even the fertilizers, we are improving the production of the grains, fruits and vegetables to meet the need of people. But the problem is, when the fruits and the vegetables are being produced in a large scale, they cannot be remain as usual because fruits and vegetables are perishable. So we need to store the fruits and vegetables and also we need to preserve. People nowadays want to process fruits. We want different kind of jam, fruit jams, juices, squashes. Okay, so these foods need to preserve because food processed at one place is transferred to other place where this kind of foods are not being prepared. So that moment we need a preservative to preserve the food. And also today's people of modern life, They also want a better look of the processed foods. So we need the food colors to improve the look. The food must be good look. So we need the food colors. Okay. So, and also because of people's needs processed food, but processed food though will use the preservatives. So again, so the carbohydrates, the fats and fats can be oxidized in the processed food. So to preserve the carbohydrates, fats, we need to stop the oxidation of the carbohydrates. For this purpose, we need the antioxidants. So, preservatives, food colors, and antioxidants are the chemicals which you are using for the food. Okay. So, in the category of food, we are eating water. Food preservatives. Number two. Food colors. Number three, your antioxidants. Okay, so in the category of food, we are using what? The basically we are going for to discuss what? Food preservative, food colors, and antioxidants. So what are food preservatives? Food preservatives are the chemical substances which can check the decomposition of the food by the microorganisms. Because the foods, the vegetables and fruits are organic matters. They are degradable. They will be decomposed by the bacteria, microorganisms. To check that, we need what will be food preservatives. Like you can use sodium benzoate, sulfur dioxide gas, different kind of epoxides are used as a food preservative. But the best example of food preservative that we are using in the home, that is called homely made food preservatives. We all know about the pickles. The pickles made in the home. Here also we are preserving the mangoes by using what? Oils, sugar, salt. So salt, sugar and oil are also the homely preservatives. Okay, in our homes pickles are there. So in the pickles, the mango, the raw mangoes are being preserved with the help of what? Salt and oil. So salt, oil and sugar are also homely preservatives. Okay. Now food colors are the chemical substances which are used to improve the look of the food, like your chicken pakoda. So where we are using the pakoda colors, okay, that is what, that you different kind of dyes, basically your azo dyes. So we are using azo dyes as you have your food colors. And your antioxidants are what? Antioxidants are the chemical substances which are used to check the oxidation of fats, carbohydrates in the processed food. Okay, so when a food is processed and stored, the carbohydrates, the fats, the oils will oxidize. To stop that, okay, we need the antioxidants. And also the antioxidants are used to check the wrinkles in the face. So we are using vitamin E. Vitamin E is one of the constituent of antioxidant. Okay. Now in addition to the food preservatives, food colors and antioxidants, also one kind of thing we are using, that is called artificial sweeteners. Okay, artificial sweeteners. Artificial sweeteners are the chemical substances
which are easy to check the calories intake in the diabetic patients. So those who are diabetes patients or those who are suffering with the obesity, they want to decrease their calories, they can use what you know, artificial sweeteners. Artificial sweeteners are sweet to taste to the tongue only, but they are not giving any calorie to the body. In fact, they are not decomposable and released as usual by the through the urine. Okay, so we have saccharin. Okay, aspartame, sucralose, L-glucose. These are the different kind of artificial sweeteners which are many more times sweetening than the cane sugars. Okay, so they are giving more sugars, so sweetest to the tongue, but are not giving any calorie to the body. Okay, so here this aspartame is stable in cold condition. Okay, stable is stable in cold condition. So the saccharins are only giving sweet taste to the tongue, but they are not decomposable and released as usual through the urines. Okay. So next we will discuss how the chemical substances are used as medicines. Okay. So medicines are the chemical substances which are used to cure the diseases. So human beings as well as animals are suffering from different kind of diseases. And to getting cure from these diseases, we need certain chemical substances known as medicines or drugs. Though the course of action and mechanism of the drugs are a vast thing, so now we will simply discuss the different kind of medicines according to their uses. Okay, so we have analgesics, antibiotics, antimicrobial, antacid, antihistamine, anti-fertility, tranquilizer. These are the different kind of medicines only in a nurse. Okay. First of all, analgesics. What are analgesics? Analgesics are the chemical substances which are used to reduce the pain. Any kind of pain in the body due to surgery, due to external, okay, or anything. So whenever there is a pain in the body due to inflammation of the tissues, that pain can be reduced by using certain chemical substances or drugs which are neurologically active drugs. Okay, they can reduce the pain. Okay. And now this analysis here, we can use what are mainly aspirin. Aspirin is one of the most important analgesic. In addition to this, also we can use your paracetamol, okay, and so many other kind of analgesic medicines are there. But this analgesics is up to two kind. One can say narcotic another value non-narcotic.
Narcotics are those analgesic drugs which can reduce the body pain by creating unconsciousness in the body and also causing the sleep. But these are getting addicted by the patient. The patient which will take narcotics will be addicted by that medicines. Okay? But non-narcotic are those analgesics which once a patient will take, okay, or if he or she will take several times, but he or she will not be addicted. Okay? So the narcotic analgesic drugs like heroin, morphine, codeine, basically these are the derivatives of opium. Okay? So heroin, codeine and morphine are the narcotic type of analgesics, but aspirin, paracetamol are the non-narcotic type of analgesic medicines. Okay? So here aspirin, paracetamol and many more are there. Okay? Morphine, codeine, etc. Okay? Analysis. Now, antipyretic are those chemical substances which are used to reduce the body temperature to the normal state. So whenever we are suffering with fever due to some reason, okay, our body temperature becomes high above 98.4. Okay, now to bring down the temperature to the normal state, we are using the antibiotics. Okay, so antibiotics say when you are using paracetamol, it is a popular antibiotic. Okay, aspirin is a popular analgesic painkiller. Paracetamol is a popular antibiotic. Okay, but paracetamol can be used for value analysis and also aspirin can be used for value the antibiotic. And nowadays, aspirin is also being used for the heart patients because it is having the tendency to reduce the blood clotting factor. It can reduce the blood clotting. Okay, that's why the aspirin is also used for the heart patients. Okay, so aspirin and paracetamol both are analgesic as well as antibiotic. Clear? Now we discuss what the antimicrobials. Antimicrobials are those chemical substances which are used either to kill the microorganisms, bacteria, algae, fungus, or to inhibit the growth of the microorganisms. Either they stop, they kill the microorganism, or they can inhibit the growth of microorganism. Okay, and this antimicrobial you can divide into three types. Okay. Antibiotic, antiseptic, and disinfectant. So, antibiotic, antiseptic, and disinfectants are the three different kind of antimicrobials which we are using either to kill the germs, bacteria, microorganism, or inhibit the growth of microorganism. Okay. Now, what are antibiotics? Antibiotics are those chemical substances which are synthesized partially or wholly. Okay.
chemical substance so, to destroy the microorganism or to inhibit the growth of microorganism which we are using for the human beings or animals so, as oral medicines so, okay, or in the form of injections okay and this antibiotic can be bactericide or can be bacteriostatic. Bactericides are the antibiotics which are used to kill the bacteria, kill the microorganisms. But the bacteriostatic are the antibiotics which are used to stop the growth, to inhibit the growth of the microorganisms. Okay, here you can say the penicillin. Penicillin is one of the antibiotic which we are using just to kill the microorganisms only. For example, tetracycline, erythromycin. These are the antibiotics which you are using to stop or to inhibit the growth of the microorganisms. Okay. Again, this antibiotics can be what you know, can be your broad spectrum or can be what you know, narrow spectrum. Narrow spectrum antibiotics are those antibiotics which are having the specific use. They can be used either against the gram positive bacteria or against the gram negative bacteria. So these are the biological terms. Okay. So when the use of the antibiotic is specific, medical value, narrow spectrum, medical value. Narrow spectrum antibiotic like your penicillin. Okay? And when the use of antibiotic is not specific, can be used for gram positive bacteria and also can be used for gram negative bacteria, then it is called a broad spectrum antibiotic. Okay? Like your ofloxacin, okay? Or erythromycin, erythromycin, okay? So we'll have a list of the medicines. Clear? So antimicrobials are those chemical substances which are either to kill the microorganism or to inhibit the growth of microorganism. This can be antibiotic, antiseptic or disinfectant. Right? Now antibiotics are those chemical substances which are used to kill or to inhibit the growth of microorganisms in the animal as well as human beings. So, and these are synthesized wholly or partly. Okay. And can be taken orally or can be injected. Okay. And that can be your bactericide, bactericidic. Bactericides are those who can just kill the microorganisms like penicillin. Bactericidics are those who can inhibit the growth of microorganism. Okay, like tetracycline. Similarly, the antibiotics can be broad spectrum or can be narrow spectrum. If the use of the antibiotic is specific, either gram positive bacteria against you or we can use against the gram negative bacteria, then that is what you narrow spectrum, okay, like your penicillin. Okay, and if we are using either from gram positive or from gram negative, that if the use is not specific, if it can be widely used, that is what you know, the broad spectrum antibiotic like ofloxacin, tetracycline, erythromycin, etc. Okay. Now, what is the antiseptic? Antiseptics are those chemical substances which are used to kill the microorganisms and are applied on the living tissue.
for dressing up the wounds, cuts, okay, that in the skin. And we know we have many kind of antiseptics like Dettol, like Sevlon, tincture of iodine. Okay, so we have Dettol, we have Sevlon, we have Betadine, iodine. Okay, also we have boric acid. Okay, see, boric acid, so we are using using in the talcum powders. Okay, because the microorganisms are also growing in our body, need your sweat, so we are using deodorants. In deodorants also we are having some antiseptic, and also in the toilet soaps, bath soaps also we are having some antiseptic like bethanol. So bethanol is one of the antiseptic present in the bath soaps that can kill the germs of microorganisms. Okay, so we have Dettol, Sevlon, Betadine, tincture of iodine, bethanol. Okay, many are there which we can use as an antiseptic. Now your disinfectants are also the chemical substances which are used to kill the microorganism. But we are applied on the non-living tissues. From cleaning up floors, toilets, bathrooms. Okay. Example, we have phenol. Okay. 1% phenol. You can use it. Okay. We have bleaching powder. COCl2. We have chlorine. Okay, so these are the disinfectants. Okay, so disinfectant, antiseptic, antibiotic, all are the antimicrobials. Okay, so antibiotic and antiseptic can be either for the antiseptic can be either on the living tissue, this is on the non-living tissue, and this is what you know, the oral internal use. These are what you know, external use. This is external use, this is what you do, internal use. Okay, so this we are taking in the form of medicine, so oral medicine or injection. Okay, this is only we are using in the surface of the skin for wounds, okay, cuts. Now what you know, antacids. So antacids are those chemical substances which we are using for controlling, for neutralizing the acids secreted by the gastric juice in the stomach. Okay, and we can use, you know, we have many antacid medicines like ranitidine, or your Zyrtec. We have Omeprazole. Okay, we have Pantoprazole. Okay, we have sodium bicarbonate. Okay, we have hydroxide sapu, magnesium, aluminum, etc. Okay, so these are the different kind of chemicals, so substances that we are using to neutralize the excess secretion of acid in the gastric juice of stomach to control or to get relief from the heartburn. Okay. Now, antihistamine. So antihistamines are those chemical substances which are used against allergy. So when person is suffering with sneezing, cold, cough, the sneezing, cold and cough are because of the allergies. We are having a chemical secreted in our body called histamine, and this histamine is responsible for causing the allergies. So to stop this histamine secretion, so we can use your antihistamine. Okay, because cetirizine. Okay, cetirizine is one of the most best example of antihistamine drug. And sometimes this antihistamine, so actually the histamine is also controlling the secretion of acid in the gastric juice. Okay, so for controlling the hyperacidity also we can use your antihistamines. So antihistamines are usually anti-allergic as well as antacid. Okay. Now your antifotility. Antifotulicy are those chemical substances which are exclusively used for females. Okay, for controlling of bath. Okay, or these are used against the protection of pregnancy. Okay. Mifepristone, okay, is one of the medicine, and many are there. Okay, these are used for your anti-fertility drug. Okay, to check the unwanted pregnancy, we are using the anti-fertility drugs. The anti drugs are only meant for the females. Then tranquilizers are those chemical substances which are used for the mental patients. Okay, so those who are suffering with anxiety, depression. Okay, so tranquilizers are used for them. Okay, so they can be hypnotics, they can be sedative. Okay, hypnotics are sleep producing. Okay, so hypnotic medicines, sedative medicines or antidepressants can change your mood or the mood elevators. Okay, hypnotics are sleep inducing. Okay, so like medicine like Equalin. Okay, Luminal. Seconal. And many are there. So these are the medicines which are used as tranquilizers. Okay. Now another one, what your soap and detergent. They are the cleansing agents. So for washing up clothes and also for body wash, we are using different kind of soaps. Okay. For cleansing of clothes, we are using detergents and for washing up our bodies, we are using the bath soaps, and also sometimes we are using soaps for washing up the clothes. Okay. So soaps and detergents are the cleansing agents which are used to remove the dirty dark particles from the body and also from the clothes. Okay, so soaps and detergents. Soaps are the either sodium or potassium salt of higher fatty acids like palmitic acid, stearic acid, oleic acid, etc. So potassium salt of higher fatty acids are soft. They can be used as part of the bath soaps or toilet soap. Whereas sodium salt of higher fatty acids are hard soaps, and they are used for the purpose of washing up the clothes. Okay, and these soaps are manufactured under the principle of saponification reaction, and soaps are biodegradable. Clear? So these soaps which we are using for the process of washing up the clothes, we can use them with soft water, but when we have hard water, we cannot use the soap for washing of the clothes.
the unnecessarily there will be a huge consumption of this salt. So to meet this, next thing you discover your detergents. So detergents are primarily used for washing purpose, but we have different kind of also. Okay, the detergents can be also ketonic, can be also anionic, or can be also neutral or non-ionic detergents. And the detergents are bio non-degradable. Okay, regarding this cleansing action of this soap and detergent, so that we will discuss in the another chapter. Okay, that is surface chemistry. Okay, thank you. So these are the how the chemicals we are using in the form of food preservative, food colors, artificial sweetener, and antioxidants. Okay, so food preservatives, as already we have discussed, these are the examples: sodium benzoate, epoxide, sodium metabisulfate, sodium and calcium salt of propionic acid, and homemade preservatives like salt, oil, sugar. Now you know food colors, you can use iodine for red color, you can use pyrethrum dye for yellow color, we can use indigo for blue color, and we can use trimethyl for green color. Similarly, artificial sugars, you can use saccharin, aspartame, sucralose, erythritol, and L-glucose. Remember, aspartame is stable in cold condition. But the sucralose is stable in cooking temperature. Next, we have antioxidants like BHT, butyrated hydroxytolol, and BHA, butyrated hydroxy anisole. In addition to this, also because the vitamin E is also a constituent of antioxidants. Okay. So these are the summary of different kind of drugs. Okay. You can see here analgesic drugs. Already we have discussed. These are the drugs which are used to reduce the pain. Okay. You can narcotic like your morphine, codeine, heroin, and non-narcotic like aspirin, paracetamol, ibuprofen, diclofenac, sodium, analgin, novalgin. Similarly, antibiotic is to reduce the fever, body temperature, paracetamol, aspirin, novalgin, phenacetin. Antibiotics are used to kill the microorganisms. They call penicillin, ofloxacin, tetracycline, erythromycin, ampicillin, and amoxicillin. Okay. Now your antiseptic is to destroy the microorganism. Okay. In the living tissue, like Dettol, Sevlon, Celon, Furacin, Betadine, tincture of iodine, mercury chloride, 0.2% phenol, bromine, and sulfamycin. Similarly, disinfectant is to kill the microorganisms and even in the non-living tissues, non-living places. So 1% phenol, CaCl2, which is bleaching powder, SO2, H2O2, solution of Cresol. Okay, and here you see one thing, 0.2% phenol is what you know, antiseptic, but 1% phenol is what you know, disinfectant. Okay, remember this, 1% phenol can be used as a disinfectant, but 0.2% phenol can be used as a antiseptic. Similarly, antiperspirant drugs, morning after pill, okay, Meftal, Mifepristone, and Norethindol. Okay, similarly, antacids are the medicines which are used to check the release of acids on the gastric juice, okay, to control the hyperacidity. Okay, and so Rantidine, Amiprazole, Cimetidine, sodium bicarbonate, mixture of sodium magnesium and aluminum hydroxides are the different kind of antacids. Similarly, antihistamine is to use against the allergic, they are called also anti allergic medicines, like cetirizine, promethazine, terphenidine, bromocriptine. These are the different kind of anti allergic medicines. Similarly, tranquilizer, okay, can be sedative, can be hypnotic, can be antidepressant. Okay, so compose, equanil, serotonin, seconal, luminal are different kind of tranquilizer medicines. Okay.